one of the biggest hassles with 3D printing is when you have a spool that is partial and you have to think, do I have enough on that spool to print what I want? Or am I going to have to sit here, babysit it, manually refill it? Or do I just have to take that spool of filament and set it aside? Today's video is a product feature. This is a product that I was going to purchase myself with my own money, but I was able to hook, line, and sinker the company into sending me one. This is a tool review, but in the end is an awesome, awesome product for anyone in the 3D printing industry. This is the InfinityFlow S1 Automatic Filament Refill System. This is one machine that's truly universal that will no longer have you fretting over, do I have enough filament to print that file? I'm able to just load up two spools, rock and roll, and throw my cares to the wind. As we open the box, just full disclaimer, guys, I saw this online on some Facebook ads or Instagram ads and reached out to InfinityFlow 3D to see if they would be interested in sending me one of these so I can show it off to you guys as well. I plan on fully purchasing several of these for my own print farm usage, but figured, hey, if I can get one to show you in a video, we can take a look. That's a great place to start. So right out of the box, this is a 3D printed item, which I really like. Some people may not. I really like it because this shows the ingenuity and resourcefulness of small business manufacturing with 3D printers. Too many people have old school thoughts that you can't really run a manufacturing business or get good quality parts from an FDM printer, and that simply is not true. So with everything out of the box, you can see the full complete kit. You've got individual small parts in their own little bags with labels. That is awesome. It tells you what everything is. For example, this is the Bamboo A1 adapter. This is an Adventurer 5M adapter, so a Flashforge adapter. And here is another Bowden repair guide, things like that. Down here are more Bowden tube or PTFE tube couplers. And then here are the roller side hardware. Everything's packed in their own little bags, labeled and clearly visible. So this portion, this is the meat and taters of the whole invention. This is the actual refill or what really makes things work. You've got two extruders, or rather not extruders, but two motors that feed filament through, combine it into one, and has sensors built in to know when one is empty, it automatically pulls from the next. You can purchase just this portion by itself to make your own kit, or you can get the rollers like I did to attach for 1 kilogram spools, 3 kilogram, or even 5 kilogram. They sell multiple different sizes, so that is really cool. As far as the rollers, these are 3D printed as well. They have bearings pressed into each end, so that is awesome. You got long life, longevity there, nice smooth rolling action, yet it is still a 3D printed product. I'm going to take a little bit of time to look at the instructions on their website and get this thing assembled properly. I will roll the footage so you can see it happen, but this is not going to be a how-to assemble because honestly, their documentation on their site is perfect. Honestly, guys, considering I did this for the first time ever right here on camera, this is really easy to put together. I really get a kick out of it and enjoy seeing the ingenuity of this since it is a 3D printed product, and that's the business that I'm also in. Seeing how they worked out the hardware, the bearing, pressing, using little bolts as miniature axles, all of that was really, really cool to see. I just brought over one of my Flashforges. This is the Adventurer AD5M. And in my instance, I had this running to a PTFE tube, so I already have a coupler here. So I'm going to use the tube that comes in the kit, attach it right here, and leaving it long on purpose just for this demonstration, connect it up front. So now we have the S1 filament system, our extra long tube, but then it also connects into the machine. What I want to do first is load up some filament. So we're going to be using green. I want to make sure when we load this in that the filament feeds over to the back, because these tubes in the back are what you want your filament to go into. So we will do that. Start it in here. And then I'm going to take my other color, which is going to be white, because I want this test to have two different colors. And I'm going to load it on this side. Again, the same way, filament coming from the front, over the top, and down to the tube in the back. I just took both of the filament ends out of the machine because I want to turn it on. And we have two status lights. You have red that tells us that both sides are empty. I'm going to feed in the green filament first, just pushing it into the tube. We get the green light here. And now it is feeding it all the way through our extra long PTFE tube, and it's going to take it all the way to the extruder. All right, let's go ahead and end the machine here. Let's tell it we want to refill our filament. This is PETG, so we'll click on start. And what it's doing now is heating up the extruder head. And whenever it starts to feed through, then I'll turn the S1 filament feeder and let it feed into the extruder. I think it's going to be the best thing to do. There we go. So now I'll feed it into the extruder and then press the button on the screen here, and it's going to go ahead and feed this the rest of the way in. Much better. Now over here as it feeds, we can see that this one is also working. Every once in a while you see the roll move, so it is keeping its pressure as it's designed to, feeding the extruder as it needs. So spinning on around, let's go ahead and load up our roll of white filament. And this one is just going to go right in here in this tube. And we should see that light go from red to green. It may be waiting for the green one to stop pulling through. Yeah, there we go. See how it turned to blue? So that is idle. Now we'll push the white filament in. It turns green. Might be a little difficult to see, but it is green, and so now we are good to go. While the nozzle is heating up and it's going through the auto bed level procedure, I went ahead and turned this around to the back, or well, maybe this would be the front, actually. Either way, got it to where we can face these, we can see these, because once it starts printing, I will snip the green filament here. It'll pull it through, and what we want to see is that it automatically refills with this second spool. See how well it catches up in the PTFE tube and what it actually looks like as it runs on the print job. Things we're looking for are any kind of gaps in the layer that would show us that it wasn't able to pick up on the refill and keep it right there together. Possible misses, maybe color bleed through. We're looking for that kind of stuff. This is kind of the what you wouldn't normally do, right? It's designed to have the same color, same filament, but this is a way for us to be able to visually inspect that color change for any kind of weirdness and know exactly where it did happen. All right, here we go, guys. The beginning of our test print. I'm going to let it do the first layer completely in green. That way we get a nice base. Has a nice solid color. Then I'll reach over, snip the green filament as it starts layer two, and we'll see how it goes. All right, this guy is off and running. I'm going to go ahead and snip it early because I'm concerned it may not make it all the way through the tube until we finish this print job. So here you can see it being pulled through the adapter. Once it reaches the runout sensor, I expect this green light to turn red and then the one on the white spool to turn green to tell us it is pulling from that spool next. There we go. It just switched over. As you can tell, it's feeding in the white roll. Our green light turned red for the green spool, and our yellow light turned green for the white spool. The white has made it through the tube a little bit, so I can reach back here and let you guys see. Look at that junction point. They are exactly aligned with each other. There is no gap there, which is awesome. That's exactly what this product is designed to do. It keeps continuous pressure on the filament and keeps them right there beside each other as it works its way in through the tubing and to the extruder. I'm glad I snipped that early because we got a little ways to go until we start to see the white filament come through the extruder. Hopefully, we get there before the model finishes. While we're waiting for the white filament to make its way through the tube, can we just take a second to appreciate this first layer quality? I think a lot of times people give Flashforge grief, or they think because it is a budget printer that you're not going to get good results. But look at this. It is not PLA. This is PETG filament. And this little dude is laying it down like mother's love. Smooth as peanut butter on a summer day. You cannot ask for better results. This is why you calibrate your filament. You get beautiful results. And this is just another example of Flashforge really needs some love. It's going to be hard to see on camera, I believe, but right here where my hand is, this is where we have the green and the white filament joint, right here. So we are just about to the point where we're going to see some color change. All right, I don't know if the camera is picking it up just yet. You might be able to see it up there in that corner. We are getting some fading on that green color, which means the white filament has made it to the extruder. The machine never missed a beat. It didn't know anything was happening. And now we are getting the fade from green to white. All right, at this point, we have our color change done. I'm going to go ahead and cancel the print job. There's no need in wasting the white filament. We have our color change. We have our nice fade. And now we'll be able to take it off the printer and take a look at this thing to see how it really looks up close. Look at that. That is a beautiful fade. There is absolutely no difference other than color on that layer. There's no missing edges, there's no gaps, there's no under extrusions. It just is a color fade. That is fantastic. That is so awesome. Well, guys, I stopped with the print job early because we got what we needed to see. And honestly, it's amazing. I really was not expecting that to handle the filament change as smoothly as it did. I figured, okay, there's probably going to be some anomalies. We're going to be able to see it there, and it'll probably just get buried through your layer lines. Hopefully, it doesn't happen on a top layer, but that's nothing to worry about. I cannot feel any bit of difference in this. And if I look, the only difference I see is color. The extrusion, the layer line, everything looks identical. It feels so cool to say this, but this truly is a product that lives up to the advertising that I've seen. It works just as well as you would expect. It truly is universal. It doesn't care what machine it goes to. It just wants a tube to push the filament through, which is awesome. It means if I want to change from Flashforge to Bamboo Lab to Creality to whatever other company out there decides to have a printer in my shop or I decide to buy, this machine can handle it. I'm not stuck in an ecosystem because I have this automatic filament refill system that only works with one brand. This is so cool. I'm probably geeking out more than you would think I should, but for me, with my print farm, especially with my Flashforge printers, where I've only had just one spool, this allows me to load up two rolls of filament and not care about how much is left on one spool, knowing it'll just pick up the second spool, keep going, and my prints won't suffer. I no longer have to calculate visually if I have enough filament to do a print job or think that I need to be in my shop to visually watch it and change it out when it runs out. I just need to make sure there's spools on both ends and I'm good to go. This is fantastic. I had more planned for this. I had more expectations or figured I would run into issues, maybe have to do some more tweaking, but I didn't. And that's fantastic. Well, guys, if you got any questions or comments, leave them for me down below. If you want to check out this product, there's a link to it down below as well. Definitely give InfinityFlow some love. Support them. They are a small US-based business. They have got a great invention. And honestly, like I said, I think they're worth spending some money at because their product is top-notch. Otherwise, thanks for watching. As always, take care, and I'll see you guys next time in the workshop.